So it's the moment we've all been waiting for. I woke up, like, I don't know, 15 minutes ago. It's like 10 a.m. in New York. And I'm like, oh shit, the new Mgk Trippie Redd album came out. They have a documentary that's dropping today. If I'm screaming, it's because I have these headphones on and it sounds like I'm not talking loud enough. And I just was like, fuck, what kind of video should I make today? I'm like a day behind. I've been working. I've been a little bit busy. And I was like, no better time than right now to fucking review some of my favorite artists' new records. So let's get into it. And this album is called A Genre Sad Boy. It's an EP. And let's check it out. The first track is Lost Boys. They're all featuring Trippie Redd.
I guess I lost my life again. It's just one of those nights.
Cool. It has a vibe. He's singing like acoustic guitars. It almost gives me like an XXXTentacion vibe. Setting the tone for an album that could be a lot different. 808.
I recorded two tonight. One is for all those
sick.
I love. This one's for the suicide. Everything is blue inside. Everyone ain't you and I. People
Mgk is just so good at doing those, like, everything's suicide. Fun of a two and lie. Like, just saying some words and it's like responding to it. He did it in that the new single, Don't Let Me Go. It's just like very original to him and it's sick. The reason behind the style is like just copy and pasting and cutting in. That's something you would see a lot, like very blatantly with like Juice WRLD, where he would just do like sloppy punch-ins and he didn't really give a fuck. And it's like Mgk could pull it off this way, but like the mindset and thought behind actually making lines that come that direct on the beat one after another is really like from modern recording. So let's keep going.
About you until you die.
I just want to get to the chorus.
I guess I lost my life again.
Nice. So Trippie's on the chorus. It's nice. I like this. This is a nice way to start off the EP. All right. Next song is Beauty. All right. Interesting. Clean guitar sample that's happening frequently.
Hope this wasn't fentanyl. Behind this camouflage, it's always my fucking fault, but I don't want to let go, let go.
Interesting. This is cool. This is like, this is Beauty, and this is like more EDM feeling, but modern and alternative.
I'm suffering from
nice rapping.
I need a hit of euphoria. I'm stuck in disturbia. I got this pain in my gut like a hernia. I got the jitters, they worrying. I don't take out, I just order it. Cross the Arizona border and ship across the sand like the Mandalorian. 21 days.
It's cool. Not my favorite, but it might grow on me. A song that I fucking love by both of them is like Candy. That shit is so sick. It's one of my favorite songs. Love the video and I listen to that song all the time. And then Mgk, like, I'm a huge fan of a huge part of his catalog, but a song that I listen to all the time that feels like is the direction he's going is like A featuring Lil Wayne. So I just want to throw that in there really quick. If you guys are fans of that, let me know in the comments. Let me know what songs you like on this album and that you don't. Also, I'm Alex Majewski, also known as JSky. This is Time Travel. A lot of these are sounding like fucking like sample, like the samples remind me of just shit from the mid-2000s, like emo rap. Pandemic times. The production's like way better, but just the way I'm hearing those like high pitched samples, that's kind of what I'm feeling.
Ain't this what we made for? Light a blunt, jump on a cloud, and then I fly away, and I can make it rainstorm. I've been up this day four, chopping up cocaine more, pulling out in that rave car, pistol in the side door. What you feel alive for? This ain't what we cry for, this ain't what we die for. Keep a missile, that's my sidearm. Leave out the crib and all black with a mask, got me feeling like Christian Bale. I gotta cross out the faces on pictures, cause everyone dead or end up in jail. Fucking this bitch from the back, but I won't say her name, cause I don't kiss and tell. No, that I'm heaven sent, but off the medicine, bitch, I might just give him hell. We gon' ride
sick.
For this.
That's we fucking sick.
For this.
As like the beat's coming in, it's actually just like a rifle cocking.
We gon' ride for this.
That's fucking sick.
Back outside with this.
They sound good together. Yeah. It's cool. It's like, it's more like fucking bars. Like, it feels more like verses on verses. What there is a divine chorus, but it's not like a chorus like you would typically hear for like a radio hit. But the shit's cool. And like, as I have more time to really dive into like what they're saying, I think it's going to be very cool because like the flows are nasty and stuff, but these don't sound like off the bat. Not all of them don't sound off the bat, just like radio friendly songs. Not that the radio fucking really matters anymore. And I don't think that's really what they're going. I think they're going to just like fucking vibe out, spit some bars, tell their truths, because they're just staying super honest with shit and the production's nasty. Next up is Struggles. Sick. I probably spoke too soon because this sounds a lot more mainstream. Wonder what makes me happy again. Now we're alternative. What the fuck makes me happier, friend? This sounds so good though. Hope that I die with a happier end. Not a thing, not a ring can make me. Let me know your favorite comments on this record. Let me know your favorite song on the record in the comments. I really don't. Well, actually, I kind of have an idea what MGK is gonna do. Let's do it. Let's see. Just a harmonizing chorus. This is a vibe for sure. Let me fast forward a little. This is like pleasant. It's not like the craziest fucking thing I ever heard in the world, but there's still like 5 or 6 more songs left. Suddenly. Cool.
Hey, I got drugs.
They're doing something cool here in the way that they're producing like the guitars and the synths. And everything is not like straight out of the box. They're like kind of morphing, distorting, doing different things to kind of create a very futuristic modern sound on everything, which I dig. If I can come back to you, then let's talk like I'm gone forever. I'd buy back the time with Sick. You. I wasted. It's better late than never. All right, half dead. It's like a rain crying. They're like side chaining like the keyboard. Some chorus on it. Yeah.
Woke up sad, then a fuck. Woke up sad. Guess I'm happy when I'm sad as a frolic cause I'm all alone. Don't even call me, leave a message at the tone. Your petty ass to hurt me to the bone. Who deserve to wanna even sing no singy songs? But my mind. Sing them anyway. But my mind.
This is cool, this is cool. And he has like the snot cry thing. MGK's verse is cool. Not my favorite. Once I get into the record, this is my first time listening to it. I'm probably gonna fuck with this stuff a lot more once I could attach to some of the words and listen to the story more. But it's that first glance where I'm being like as judgmental as possible, hoping for another fucking 10 songs like A. This is like my response to it. This is cool. Sick. This is Hiding in the Hills. Who's producing this shit, by the way?
But it's not where I belong. I don't have no friends in this motherfucking room. When does all this end? I've been staying up till dawn. Running by myself, but the devil came along. Yeah. Roll it, roll it, roll it, roll it up. I'm trying to smoke. Pose it in this cloud. It look like I'm turning to ghost. Got a lot of problems that I'm wearing on my soul.
Yeah, few producers. Slim's on a lot of it. And I believe that's like his boy forever. This is truly like they titled it like that. This is an emo rap record. They're not trying to do anything that it's not. They're trying to do some shit that they like, and I do think there's a big audience for it. Emo rap fans are very live and well, and they're fucking waiting for some good shit. The thing is that a lot of people have a lot of negativity towards MGK, But I don't know if that's as much from like pop, sorry, I don't know if that's as much from emo rap people as it is from like the alternative pop punk side of things. Nonetheless, having songs with Trippie Redd, who is a person that is a bit more respected, as he's like an OG coming up like with X and other rappers. So I think this could be good for both of them. I just feel like this is a true thing. They're saying, like, I don't have any friends in this motherfucking room. Like, these are people who are extremely famous. People are probably trying to always take advantage of them. And it just gives, like, the sense of kind of, like, what do they call it? Hiding in the hills. Like, just being in the great, like, one of the most pretty places ever. Somewhere that everyone wants to be, yet they feel so alone. And I feel like that's coming through from the lyrics and the music that I'm hearing in the song. Now is No More.
Yeah.
I like the vibe of this.
Hey, I don't make friends no more. I don't take Xans no more. I can't pretend no more. These thoughts won't end no more. I don't do trends no more. I'm not like them no more. I don't look up no more. Don't give a fuck no more.
A many ends right now. Devil's dens right now. Cardi lens right now. And death spins right now. I'm off the hinge right now. My sin right now. None to give right now.
Very simplistic.
No one to call no more.
Now we're in the number 9 track called Who Do I Call? Cool.
Where do I go from here? Who do I know here? I want it all again. Who can I call again? Percocet crawling my skin.
Everything is great without you. There's nothing to save if I'm here without you. I picked up the phone, I'm finna dial you. You said you're alone, but I really doubt you.
I never had that, so if you put it in very my chill vision, I'ma grab that. I never been a nigga that them bitches laughed at.
Yeah, the main producers on the record is Slim X, Slim Double X, which is his boy. He might even play in the band. I see him all the time with him in photos and shit like that. I think they were friends, like, in Ohio. But correct me if I'm wrong. Then you have Charlie Handsome, who's on most of the tracks. And then Blaze X. Yeah, like, the production is high quality. The thing that I'm hearing here is, like, when MGK does stuff by himself, I do feel like they dive a little bit more into the songwriting. Since this is, like, an emo rap record and he's collaborating throughout the whole process with Trippie Redd, it feels like they're going a bit... they're being a little bit more creative and loose with the form, where if he was doing this, like, independently, he might bring in another writer or two and really just, like, work with the producers who are on it to, like, kind of crack the code and make, like, the best song possible. But overall, this is just like a really cool emo rap record. And now let's go to the final one called Summer's Gone, which I like that title. It stood out to me like before I went to listen to it. Doing that very like kind of intimate, cheap in your face acoustic that I would hear on X Records back in the day.
Leave me out to
but it's cool so far. Static in the background.
Obviously I cry a lot. Want me to stuck in my head, I try a lot.
I can't quiet my thoughts. Don't let them out this Pandora's box. I ruined my wedding, now I wish I had a rope so I could still tie the knot. Leave my body cold as the north. Hanging from the ceiling fan, spinning in circles. That young leave a beautiful corpse.
Like, a lot of this stuff reminds me of like interludes on Tickets to My Downfall and the follow-up record that MGK had, like almost like Twin Flame and shit like that. Like, things that he wanted to capture to be the vibe throughout and in between the records. A lot of that stuff is kind of like worked out here, which is cool. It feels more like a voice memo or just like a message where they're really sharing like their inner feelings, which I really fuck with. You know, this isn't a record that I think their plans are always to make noise, but I don't think their plans are to make a record to be fucking number one singles, although some of these might turn into that just because they're good. Yeah, so let's just fast forward to the end. Cool. So we just finished the new MGK Trippie Redd EP. Definitely emo rap inspired. Two great artists who came together and they are just like really putting it out there, telling their story. Just almost feels like notes, voice memos, shit that they had on their mind and ideas, and they're collaborating with some of their best friends and they're just making some fucking art. I really fuck with it. On like a scale of 1 to 10, and I hate to rate something, especially on like a first listen where I'm like listening, but I'm like talking shit, I would give this like a 6.5, 7. That would be my honest rating. That's pretty fucking good. You know, if I would base like a song that MGK has to be like a 10, that's like rap alternative, like kind of like this, I would say the song A with Lil Wayne, fucking 10 in my book. Candy with Trippie Redd, a 10. So if you want to kind of compare and see where I'm getting this like off the cuff number from, it goes against those songs. Those are like fucking perfect. Like everything about it is just like one great thing on top of the other. There's a lot of elements in here that are like that, and there's some potential for it to grow on me as they're brand new to me. My name's Alex Majewski, also known as JSky. Thanks for tuning into the video. Watch me review my first record on YouTube. I haven't done anything like this before. I just woke up. I saw my phone that the record was out. I was like, fuck it. This would be a cool way to make a video this week. I need something that I want to do anyway. So I was like, let's go. I appreciate everyone for tuning in. Let me know in the comments what you guys think. Follow me on Instagram, subscribe to the channel, and I'll see you guys next week. Peace.